Back inside Goodman Stadium in Bethlehem, 50-28, Lafayette takes the Patriot League crown. Without any further ado, in the mayhem down on the field behind us, let's get to John Leone, our head coach, with the head coach, Frank Tavani, with his fourth title.
Yes, you, Matt. Coach, a lesson, an absolute display of persistence all year long.
Well, I got to hand it to our young men, our staff. Everybody stayed together. When we were 1-5, people just counted us out except us. And this group, all our kids, the staff, and great effort. I'm happy for our alumni and everybody else. Give an effort on out there. I just want to reach out to Aubrey Bumbach and her family. She's fighting a heck of a fight right now, and we put a lot of energy into caring about everybody in our community.
Coach, that's a characteristic that follows a team no matter what the goal is. I have to tell you, you know, we talked about this. You were 1-5, but you can't do it without, you talked about senior leadership all year long. You had it. That's one of the reasons why you never gave up.
Well, there's no doubt about it. We said all along, when we recruited this group of seniors, when they were freshmen, we said this is a talented group. They had enough talent and the courage to win a championship. And I couldn't be happier for a group of young men right now.
Coach, I know you want to get inside with your team. That's the most important thing right now. Do that. We hope we can get back to you a little bit later. If not, we'll catch up.
We want to get together and have our moment. We're going to come out, and then we're going to party like it's 1999.
Okay, hot dog. Take care, baby. Gary, Michael, Matt, back to you.
Thanks. So 1994, the last time this team was an outright Patriot League champion. Of course, they had a co-championship in 2006 to get to the postseason. But you have to feel good for Frank Tavani. I know I want to ask you about the mayhem down behind us. But, I mean, this guy, you know, there are always people who say, well, maybe it's time to move on.
Sure.
Maybe it's time to look for a new coach. Frank Tavani stayed with his system, and things started working. And in the end, look at this amazing run to get to the postseason.
It really is amazing. And then, like you said, you're always going to have your Monday morning quarterbacks. You know, they're going to question what you're doing, especially when you're down. But like you said, he just stuck with his plan, changed it up a little bit, and obviously got some great play out of the freshman, Drew Reed, and look where they are now.
What's going on down there? I mean, what went on?
Well, you know what?
Final buzzer sounded.
You know, it's just madness. And I'll tell you, you know, there's just nothing like it. It's almost indescribable. You know, for those guys, especially the seniors, you know, some guys might have been around for 5 years. You know, that for these young kids, that's almost a quarter of their life. They're around with these guys that they've bled with, they've sweat with, they've trained with for all this time, and now to combine that with such a big game and with history like this, it's just indescribable.
Oh, great for those players down there. Now, we're going to have more about our thoughts about what changed this game and made things turn the way the Lafayette Leopards needed them to go to win this title. But without any further ado, let's head back to the booth. We've got highlights. They're good ones. So, to Gary and Mike, let's see the highlights from the second half of play.
Here we go. We're going to get the highlights right now. And I tell you, Lafayette had a lot of them from start to finish. They've done that the last 2-3 weeks. Everything's been good the last 10, 15 quarters. This one here, on the ground, you're going to see Ross Sherman pick it up, take it into the end zone. That's after a Ross Sherman long kickoff return. Got the ball down to about the 30. Going to take a look here now. 7-0 lead, and Drew Reed's going to throw this ball down the field to Mark Ross. Mark Ross for the touchdown. That's after a long penalty. Remember, this was a fourth down play, which Frank Tavani decided to go for. And Mark Ross, the senior, comes up big at 14-0. In the second quarter, you know, Lehigh started to come back after a blocked punt. They're going to take this ball down into the end zone here, and this is going to be Tyler Coyle. Ran a great route. Good delivery by McHale. It's 14-7. Lafayette, you know, it comes back. They run a little flea flicker right here, gets the ball. That was a big Justin Adams possession right there. He had a great catch for a first down. He had the flea flicker, and then he had this one right here to walk into the end zone on a blown coverage. Lafayette at that point, 21-7. In the third quarter, halftime 21-14, Drew Reed comes out. He's going to make a throw down the field, sees Mark Ross. Mark Ross is going to leave his feet. That's a senior, and Phil Ng talked about it. Going out and doing what you need to do. Ross shaking up on the play. He would return, but he got that ball down close enough to the end zone for the best blocking play of the day. Marcellus Irving comes in for that one play to spell Ross Sherman. And Lafayette takes a commanding lead at that point in time. They were up 2 touchdowns. So Lafayette right now trying to come back again here. Here's the toss outside. A great call by Mickey Fine. Remember, that was on a 4th-and-1. Lafayette takes the lead there. 36-14 at that point in time. They had a 2-score lead. At the beginning of the fourth quarter, you know, Lafayette kind of got a little closer there. And this was a huge play. Demetrius Dixon, this is, remember, this was an 8-point lead by Lafayette. Lehigh had just scored 14 points. A great block by Mark Ross. Going to peel field back. Demetrius Dixon, that was a one-play drive, 68-yard touchdown. And then you're going to see Tyrus White right here. Tyrus White's been exceptional. Kasha on the pickup. The defense stepped up at the end. All phases for Lafayette contributed, especially into the fourth quarter. But this was just a great win for Lafayette. An absolutely incredible day. You know, you and I just enjoyed it. You, me, and Pete, I tell you, we had a wonderful time up here. I got warmer as the fourth quarter went on.
Yeah, no question about it. Just some numbers to give you. Ross Sherman, 106 yards rushing, two touchdowns. Mark Ross, 127 receiving yards and a touchdown. Demetrius Dixon, 107 yards receiving and a touchdown. Justin Adams, 92 yards receiving and a touchdown. Drew Reed, 20 for 27, 378 yards and three touchdown passes. And we are awaiting now the Patriot League ceremony as the trophy is there for the giving. And I will remind everybody, tomorrow at 11:30, tune in to ESPNU, and you will find out who the Lafayette Leopards will play next Saturday as the representative of the Patriot League in the FCS playoffs. We will assume that Fordham also will get an invite, as they were absolutely destroying Colgate today. The last score we saw, I think, was 42-7.
Yeah.
So I think Lafayette upset them a little bit last week, and they wanted to show the committee that they are deserving of an invitation. We don't have an official word yet on the MVP. We did hear that it was Drew Reed, but that has not been officially announced. But for now, we're going to head back to Matt Province and Phil Ng. And guys, what a great, great day up here in the booth. We're a lot warmer now than we were.
Yeah, you know what? They're going to do
I'll tell you what, Gary, it was also very fun on the sidelines as Lafayette began to pull away, and the elation of knowing that this team was going to win the Patriot League Championship certainly warmed up things even down there after the sun had gone behind the clouds. So we know your elation, and we can't go wait to go back and hear the calls of the game without a doubt. But I want to further on something you mentioned too, Gary. There's going to be a viewing party tomorrow at the Kirby Sports Center. So you can go down there. There'll be a big party and a festive-like atmosphere to find out just exactly who and where Lafayette will be playing in the playoffs, presumably Saturday of next week. So that could be very exciting without a doubt. So remember, tomorrow, get up, go to Kirby Sports Center, enjoy the party. This never gets old, I would imagine. You're an athlete. You're a guy that was not only a guy individually who stood out as an All-American, but as a team player and being part of some very good teams. I mean, this is what you play for, and now they have a chance.
Oh, yeah, definitely. You know, and I wish we had a chance back in the day. You know, we didn't have a chance to go into the postseason, but it definitely is. You know, come off a win like this, win the Patriot League Championship, beat Lehigh for the first time for these seniors, and then go on and have a chance to continue your season.
How impressed were you two? There were times, and I know that we just heard Gary and Mike talk about it during the highlights, there were times in this game where it looked like, here comes Lehigh again, a team that's come back six times, a team that had been behind 20 in the fourth quarter on opening day here against Central Connecticut and won in overtime. What stands out to you that Lafayette did to make sure that didn't happen against them?
Well, I don't know if there's anything, one thing that stood out to me, but it was just the fact that, we stood our ground. You had the fact that we were never in a close game and able to pull it out. And they did. You know, we had a couple balls go our way. You know, you had the interception. You had the long pass play, and that just really helped them. Complete the game.
They really negated the Lehigh passing attack. I mean, here's an attack that has had some very big games, and to come back in games, you have to obviously be able to throw the ball. Between the pass rush, getting after the quarterbacks, the play in the secondary. I mean, they really negated a big strength for what Lehigh does offensively, I thought today. And yet, little things too. I thought Blake Searfoss, a freshman, who was way down on the depth chart beginning of the year, holding on a snap, on a botch snap, running in and completing a two. That was a nifty run.
Yes,
I mean, he was shifting on the goal line like it was Barry Sanders down there, and that gave Lafayette a little extra assurance. And
I think that's just a lot of momentum as well. It just continued that momentum. They pulled that out, and that's
all right. Let's get it up to Gary back in the booth as we're set for the presentation of the Patriot League trophy.
There is the Patriot League Executive Director, Carolyn Schlieffemovich, handing the trophy to Frank Tavani. And you see the Lafayette group so very, very happy. Mike, as you look at those guys, you look at Brad Borman, and Pat Crosby, one of the co-captains.
And Randall Logan.
Randall Logan.
There it is.
takes a lot of hard work, a lot of long days to hoist that baby.
Just an incredible feeling.
There's
for
Mark
them.
Ross.
Who deserves
Lafayette's
it
record-setting, yeah, record-setting wide receiver. And they all get to play another game.
Just exceptional. And you know what? The only better thing would be to do it at home, but you know what? It's kind of sweet to do it here as well.
And again, I don't know if we did not see it. I don't know if they've announced the player of the game, the most valuable player. We can't imagine that it would be anyone but Drew Reed. Everybody wants a picture, a shot of the celebration. I've got a few of these in my office as pictures up on my wall of Coach Devaney hoisting that trophy.
You know, that's what's amazing, Gary. And John Leon touched upon it on his last report, and so did Matt Provins. You know, you have so many people out there looking at scores, looking at what happens. But this team went through so many injuries last year. And then early this year, they started to get some players back, get some depth. Remember, they moved guys from offense to defense to play secondary play. And that guy held this group together along with Mickey Fine and Hallahan and Coach McFadden and John Luce and a young Ian Dell, who did a great job with that defensive line. I mean, these coaches have done an outstanding job. That's not an easy thing to do. You get great senior leadership as well.
And we mentioned Lafayette has not won a championship by themselves since 1994. Colgate won it last year. Lehigh won it the two previous years. And Drew Reed is your most valuable player. And Mike, it's been a long, long time since a freshman has won the award. A freshman quarterback back to Phil Stambaugh.
Yeah, Phil Stambaugh in 96. And for Lafayette, it was, you got to go all the way back to Jimmy Johnson, which was 29 years ago, my freshman year, along with Frank Corbo, did a great job winning that day. But today he distributed the football, and we talked about that all year. Demetrius Dixon, early in the game, it was Brandon Hall, it was Justin Adams, it was Mark Ross making big catches. This was an absolutely huge one. Demetrius Dixon didn't catch a ball last week against Fordham, but today, when he got his hands on the football, he took it, and you got to feel great for those guys. Ben Aloy, Mike Bowles, Jake McTy, Tyler Robinson. I tell you what, these are guys that you and I, every week we live and die
yeah,
with.
Yeah.
And, you know, we don't know them as well as we feel we do, but at the same time, you can't, the smile tells everything. Every Lafayette fan got to soak this in.
Randall Logan, Brad Borman. Brad Borman, who is a true scholar athlete. He's unbelievably intelligent. He and Mark Ross are all academic all-stars, tremendous young men. They all are. I mean, we meet them every week at the press conferences. And how about Drew Reed? He's now played in three championship ball games in his life, and he has 11 touchdown passes, and he's won them all.
Yeah, he's thrown 11 touchdowns. I mean, the kid's amazing, and we forget to mention how well that offensive line played down the stretch. They were much maligned, and Stan Clayton, one of the best offensive line coaches in the country, you can swear by him. He got in their face, and you see on crutches down there, I can see Pat Crosby. They're saying maybe an MCL, so he might be able to come back from that, but they're going to miss him next week, but we'll find out where they play tomorrow.
All right, John Leon is with the record-setting Lafayette receiver, Mark Ross.
Go ahead, Coach. I tell you, we're just getting anybody we can, but I just happened to grab Mark Ross here. Mark, what a great day you've had, and tell us what it was like, the journey of this season, because that's what it was. It was an odyssey.
I mean, there's a lot of ups and downs, you know, and there's been a lot of ups and downs in my 4 years here, you know, and I think Brad Borman said it best the other day. He said that, you know, if we win this championship, that these four rough years, we could do it 10 times over again, you know. It's just that all that hard work we put in the offseason, during the season, you know, 4 years of tough up and downs, you know, it feels so good that finally paid off, you know.
You know, you absolutely paid the price. I remember the catch you made early in the game down here. Out, you got winded on it because you came down, but you absolutely laid out, gave your body up. But that's kind of illustrated what the team did all year long. And you know, Mark, I go back to the senior leadership that Coach talked about. There had to be times when the younger guys are saying, is this what it's like? Can we turn this around? And it was up to you guys to tell them you could.
I think that was the biggest thing, you know, this senior class. kept this locker room optimistic. You know, we, like I said, a lot of ups and downs this year and over the past 4 years. And, you know, I think we held the team together. And, we finally pulled everything together towards the end of the season. We came on strong, and it was most important, you know.
I had a chance to talk to your mom last weekend at your last home game. And, she was camera shy. She wasn't going to say anything. But when she finally got the microphone in front of her, the emotion just... She said, I think it'll really hit me when the band plays the alma mater for the last time. But guess what, Mrs. Ross, we're playing some more football.
It's not the last time.
You got it. Mark, congratulations. Terrific. I'm fine. Drew Reed here. I got him. Here's the young quarterback. Drew, there's a rumor around that you lied on your birth certificate because you didn't exactly play like a freshman. But this championship thing, you have a way with these championship games, don't you?
I just wanted to come out, and we all do. We just want to play our best, and me in particular, I wanted to try not to do too much. I think last week, I got a little ahead of myself and tried to do a little bit too much. So this week, I just wanted to try to get the ball to my playmakers in space and let them make plays like they did today.
During the week, there's an awful lot of talk about the magnitude of this game, how big it was. Obviously, you didn't get that memo because you were just really cool under pressure. But what did the other players have to say to you about the game and your preparation for it? How did it affect you mentally?
I mean, they just told me treat it like any other game. There's another team in our way, and we got to come out here and get this championship. And we were able to play well and do that today.
I don't know. I just want to warn you now, you can't get used to this stuff. It doesn't happen like this every year, does it? I mean,
well, hopefully we'll have some more championships for 4 years I'm here. But, it feels great. It feels great for the seniors. And I'm glad we were able to pull this one out.
Well, Drew, congratulations on a terrific start to your Lafayette career. You're going to play more football, and let's get ready for wherever we go next week. But take some time to enjoy this one.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Gary, Michael, what a scene down here. And it's just Michael, what you'd expect. You feel a real part of it. A terrific scene here at Goodman Stadium. Back to you guys.
Well, it's so nice to hear a young man with a Southern accent as the Lafayette quarterback out of Tennessee. Mike, we don't know where we'll be, whether we will be with the Lafayette Leopards next Saturday. We certainly wish them well. It's been a great season, and I can't think of a better picture for us to look at as we say goodbye to everybody. We wish all of you a very happy Thanksgiving. I think it'll be a lot happier right now for the Lafayette fans. And Matt, back to you and Phil. Thanks so much for sharing the year with us.
Now, thank you, guys. We've enjoyed what a great year to be part of Lafayette football for the first time, and hopefully we can expand on this for the future. Phil, I know it's been great, but even down to the final day on set, you said the biggest key offensively was to spread the ball around.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what they did.
Exactly. You know, what it didn't allow any defenses to do was to key on anyone. They couldn't key on Ross Sherman. They couldn't key on Mark Ross. The fact that they spread it around really got the tight ends involved and got Ross Sherman actually out into the field and in the passing game. That really helped them out. And that was key.
Drew Reed was just presented the trophy behind us, which was a great moment. We talked about it earlier in jest, but his teammates began to call him the Drew Hamid because he was almost the savior of the season. And, you know, nothing's going to stand out more to me about this game. Okay, they got off to the 7-0 lead. That's terrific. But then to be backed up and decide to go for it 4th-and-26 from the 31-yard line early on in the game in the first quarter like they did, get the touchdown hookup from Reed to Ross. To me, that's when Lafayette made that early statement like, you know what? Today's our day.
Exactly. So,
good. Out of words. Really amazing. I mean, it's just great. You see behind us all the activity. This party is going to continue to go on for a while. But remember, you can be part of the party tomorrow. They encourage you to head down to Kirby Sports Center, fill the newly renovated arena, because at 11:30, ESPNU will have the allotments of where teams are going and who they're playing and all the assignments for the first round of the FCS playoffs. You can be part of the fun tomorrow on the campus of Lafayette, 11:30 again at Kirby Sports Center. Phil, it has been an absolute pleasure. I mean, we had a great year, so it made it a lot easier, but this has been a great year.
Yes, it certainly has, and it's been a pleasure, my pleasure as well, spending it with you and Maurice on the set. Let's hope it continues.
Let's hope so. Again, next week, Gary, Mike, and John will have all the action from wherever Lafayette is stationed for the first round of the FCF playoffs, but as we go away,
away from this broadcast, we remind you that this team is the Patriot League champion here in 2013, the eighth title that this program has been able to notch, and certainly as sweet as any, because now they have beaten Lehigh to do so. Yes, on this elimination game, this essential championship game here played at Goodman Stadium. For the entire crew, we want to thank them not only for today, but their work all year long on Lafayette Sports Network. They did a fabulous job bringing you coverage of Lafayette football. And, of course, for our trio, Gary, for Mike, and for John, we want to thank you for watching this production of Lafayette Sports Network football. And remember, playoffs next week. Leopards are the champions of the Patriot League. Roll Pards.